food, eh? Sawa sawa?
Sama.
Yeah, mekula sana. And yeah, that is what we want to talk about very, very briefly. I will not take your time. I know you are very tired. Some of you are here from as early as 5 o'clock. So I will not take your time. And what is happening now, after you have eaten, there's something. I will not go very technical, and I recognize some of my colleagues in the medical fraternity. I think we have clinicians here, we have nurses, and so on and so forth. So how many come from the medical fraternity? Kuna wangapi hapa? So, medical fraternity, those who work in the medical field. Naona wengine, yes, Neema is there. So she will assist me. So tanisaidia kidogo. I think there are others, but maybe they are hiding. So sawa. So I just want to introduce, it's just an introduction of nutrition. Yeah, because nutrition is very, very wide. It's very wide because it covers nutrition in the life cycle, whereby it covers nutrition from the time a child is born. Sawa sawa? Yeah. Kabla mtoto hajazaliwa, nutrition is there. And you all know, and I know you know that there's one great nutritionist. And the best nutritionist was the one who created Adam. Isn't it?
Yes.
Yes. What did he do in the Garden of Eden? He told Adam what to eat and what not to eat. Are we together?
Yes.
Yeah, so nutrition, where did nutrition start? In the Garden of Eden. Yeah, and then before the fall, after the fall of man, when you go to the book of Leviticus, when man fell, then there were certain diets that were introduced, which were not there in the Garden of Eden. Do you know which diets those ones were? Meat, eh? They were sour. Yeah, because in the Garden of Eden, people were not eating meat. They were eating fruits. Sawa sawa. Yeah, but I'll not go into details of that. Yeah, because there are so many things. Yeah, so there's a there are issues that touch on spirituality. So nutrition started in the Garden of Eden. And it's very, very good because God wants man to be healthy. Yeah, because without being healthy, then you cannot work. You cannot serve. And so long as you have this body, yeah, so let us not, we'll not be very spiritual today. Sawa-sawa? Yeah, because we are just talking on things pertaining to the human body. So the brother who defined nutrition, you really tried. Nutrition is a process. Yeah, actually nutrition is a process. And we normally say nutrition is a science. It's a very wide area. It covers very wide because it is a science that touches on food. So there are foods, there are nutrients, and then there are other substances that also affect the food and nutrients. And these substances are known as anti-nutrients. Sawa sawa. So there are nutrients as well as anti-nutrients. Yeah, because they affect the nutrients that we take. So yeah, all these factors come into play when we are considering the type of diets that maybe we are planning, because diets have to be planned before they are taken. Without planning a diet, then you go wrong. That is where we go wrong. Yeah, because before you eat, you must, first of all, you have to have money to go for shopping. And then when you go for shopping, you have to choose the type of food to buy. And sometimes there are certain influences that affect our dietary choices, including finances. Ni kweli ama si kweli? Yeah, for instance, nikiuliza, yeah, we Kenyans, we I don't know who told us that we have to take tea and bread in the morning. Who said we have to take tea and bread in the morning?
English people.
Yeah, I'm British, eh?
Yes.
Yes. But before that, Muzungu came. What were our grandmothers taking?
Washe.
Yeah, Washe. Nduma, maybe Ugali was not even there.
Nyogo.
Because Ugali likuja pia na Mzungu. I don't know whether Ugali was there.
It was.
Yeah, because maize was introduced by, I think it came from America. Sawa, sawa. Yeah, so there were maybe the Ndumas, the Ngwashes, the Mihogos, you know, all those. Yeah. So, yeah, all those things. Yeah, so influence, cultural influences is one of the things that affect the way we eat. And it's very, very important to have these type of sessions because the overall health is affected by the things that we take in terms of diet. Yeah, how healthy or how unhealthy you will turn out to be when you start reaching your 40s, 50s, sawa, ukianza kufika 40 years, and if you have been eating poorly from 20 years, 30 years, it will catch up with you when you reach 40, 50 years. Are we together? Yeah, so you are lucky. You have to start learning these things early enough so that you avoid what we call lifestyle diseases. Eh? How many know what lifestyle diseases are? Yeah, we have a certain category of diseases that is known as lifestyle diseases. And those are the diseases that are caused by the kind of lifestyle that we live. Yeah, because we realize that nowadays, there's a lot of lifestyle changes, including the type of food we eat. We eat a lot of refined foods. Hata ile unga ambayo kwamba tunatumia kwa kupika ugali. Sio ile unga ambayo kina grandmother used to take. Sindio? And we normally say one thing in nutrition. We normally advise people that you don't take anything that your grandmother does not recognize. Sawa sawa? Are we together? So think about that. If you are taking a lot of things that your grandmother does not recognize, then you are in for trouble in future. Yeah. So lifestyle diseases are caused by the kind of lifestyle we live. There's a lot of mechanization nowadays, yeah, in terms of which affect our physical activities. Yeah, so we do little physical activities. We do little walking. Mtu akitoka hapa, akienda town, what do we take? We take a matatu, we take a boda boda, and some of the towns. Nowadays, we don't do a lot of physical activities. Yeah. And nutrition is concerned with not only diet, it's concerned with the diet and also the kind of physical activities that we do, the way we live overall. Yeah, so that one affects the overall health of a person. And in the book of Galatians, let me just quote Galatians chapter 6, verse 7, which says, "Be not deceived. God is mocked. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap." And we want to avoid a situation whereby, as youth, as the youth of today, when we reach 40, 50 years, we reap because of exposing ourselves with substances that can cause problems in the future. Okay, let me just give you an example of classes of nutrients. Yeah, because maybe you might have heard of them. but maybe you may not know how to classify them as a nutritionist. And before that, I want to just talk a little about the process of nutrition. Nutrition involves the process of ingestion. Ingestion simply means eating. Sawa sawa. Ingestion of food means eating. And then after ingestion, the next thing that happens is absorption. Or before the absorption, digestion. And then after digestion, then the body will absorb the food that we eat. And then after absorption, then the food has to be transported to the various respective cells, tissues, and organs where it is supposed to be utilized. And then, there's something else. Kuna kitu moja imebaki. Ni kitu gani? After the food has to be utilized, there's something else. Eh? Ejection. Okay. Can somebody who... Okay, you tried? Somebody else? Yes? Excretion. Thank you so much. Yeah, you look like a health worker. Yeah, so excretion. So every area that I have mentioned is very important. Every area that I have mentioned is very important. Ingestion is important. Equally, transportation is important. Equally, excretion is important. So ingestion without excretion will bring problems to your body. So let me talk about the classes of nutrients. Classes of nutrients, we have substances that are known as carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are those types of foods that provide energy to the body. They supply energy to the body. The cells of a human being need energy for them to function properly, for metabolism. I hope you know what metabolism is. So metabolism is... are those processes that provide energy to the body. Otherwise, without metabolism, you will not get any energy. So you need carbohydrates. And we can give examples of carbohydrates. Can somebody give me one or two examples of carbohydrates?
Wali.
Okay, ugali na?
KDM.
Okay, KDM? Yes. So, KDM ni nini?
KDM.
Oh, KDF. Yes. KDF. Oh, KDF is also a carbohydrate, huh? Because it comes from wheat. Sawa? Yeah. So the second class of nutrients is known as proteins. Yeah, so carbohydrates, we know that they are needed for energy. And I'll come back there. Yeah, because that is where we have a lot of problems. Eh? And that is where we have a lot of issues. Yeah, so the next class is proteins. And we can give examples of proteins. How many types of proteins do we have? We have, yes. Yes.
Plant and animal.
Thank you so much. So there's plant and animal proteins. Sawa. Mpigieni makofi. So plant proteins, an example of plant proteins is beans. Sawa. Njahe. Lentils. Kamande, and so on and so forth. Sawa. Animal proteins, fish, chicken, beef, and so on and so forth. Don't say meat, eh? So when meat is a group, yeah. So you have to go, you have to be very specific. If it is chicken is a meat, beef is a meat, mutton is a meat, pork is meat. Sawa. Yeah, so those are type of proteins. So we have two types of proteins, plant proteins and animal proteins. Then the third class is fats, or we also call them lipids. Yeah, lipids, we have... two types. We have fats as well as oils. What is the difference between fats and oils? Yeah, because there's a difference between fats and oils.
Oh,
Okay, I will help you there. Fats are solid at room temperature, and oils are liquid at room temperature. So asawa. So mark that, because we are coming back there. And we'll see which one is better than the other. Then we have another group of nutrients that is known as vitamins. Sawa. And then the other one is minerals. So other than vitamins, we have minerals. And then we have another group. Have we forgotten one? Water. Did you know that water is a nutrient? Mulijua hivyo, eh? Yeah, water is a nutrient, eh? And it is a very important nutrient. Nikiuliza hapa watu, wangapi mmekunywa angalau glasi tatu za maji since morning? Sijui nitapata wangapi. How many glasses? Three glasses since, at least three glasses since morning. Wangapi? Okay. Now, what is happening? Yeah. So water is a very important nutrient, eh? Yeah, so those are how many? How many classes of nutrients are those?
There are six.
There are six, huh? Yeah, so we have six classes of nutrients, including water. Well, there's something else that is known as fiber. Sawa?
Yeah.
Yeah, and we normally get fiber from something else.
Yeah.
We can get fiber from fruits. We can also get fiber from vegetables. We can also get fiber from legumes. We can also get fiber from cereals. Sawa? Yeah, like maize, we can get fiber. Sawa? So, but there's a reason that we don't classify it as a nutrient. It is because it is not absorbed by the body. Sawa? So when you eat fiber, when you eat a fruit or a vegetable and you get fiber, and the nutrients are absorbed in the body, then the fiber is not absorbed. What happens with it? It is normally excreted. Eh? I don't know whether you know of any city ambayo kwamba haina kanjo. City ambayo kwamba haina kanjo system will be a very dirty city that is infested with a lot of dirt, refuse, and so on and so forth. So the function of fiber ni kama kanjo ya mwili. Sawa? So what does it do? Let me use a layman's language. Eh? It keeps the gastrointestinal tract, which is the stomach, eh? And the lining, eh? the stomach and the lining. So what fiber does, it keeps the GIT clean. It sweeps. Ni kama kifagio. So fiber, usipokula fiber in your diet, then hautakuwa na kifagio ya kufagia your system. Your system will be dirty, and that is why people are having a lot of colon cancers, sawa, and other types. Toa ngozi. Yeah. You remove the skin. Tafadhali, yeah? Are we together, young people? Yes, unatoa ngozi ya kuku before you eat that chicken. And what remains actually is very healthy meat with healthy fat. And it is actually recommended. White meat minus what? Minus the skin. For fish is okay. Fish, you can take it the way it is. But for chicken, recommendation, you remove the skin of the chicken, and then you can eat the rest of the flesh. Are we together? Yes. So hiyo ni ngumu, eh?
Hiyo ni ngumu.
Yes, hiyo ni ngumu.
Hiyo ni ngumu.
Yes. And the reason is because we lack physical activity. Si ndio? Si tumekubaliana kwamba tume hapa na pale lazima tupande gari. Si ndio? Yeah. We never used to walk the way our grandmothers and our grandfathers used to walk. So we never used to hatufanyi kazi ya shamba. I know most of you are very active here. Yeah, but we are not as active as they are. So try to limit the intake of cholesterol in your body. Otherwise, you will be accumulating a lot of things. And in future, you'll have problems with your health. So white meat versus red meat. Tumeelewana? Plant proteins, hizo hazina shida. Sawa sawa. Maharagwe hayapendwi, si ndio? Maharagwe, njahe, but they are very healthy. Yeah, first of all, beans are very good, especially for the young girls here. Yeah, because they have a lot of iron. Eh? Yeah. And you know why iron is important for the young ladies here? Si ndio?
Yes.
Yeah, you need iron. But how should we take beans? You have to take beans with something else that is known as vitamin C. We call it ascorbic acid. Eh? So vitamin C inapatikana kwa vyakula gani? Can you give me examples of food sources of vitamin D, vitamin C or ascorbic acid? Oranges? Sidiyo, tulisahau science ya shule. Science. Hiyo ni vitu simple, eh? Oranges are very good sources of vitamin C. So whenever you are talking, you are taking beans, njahe, lentils, and so on and so forth, please look for vitamin C food sources. Eh? Actually, almost all the fruits and vegetables are good sources of vitamin C. And the reason we encourage intake of vitamin C with beans and family is because the vitamin C in the beans, they enhance the absorption of what? Of iron in the beans. Niposa wa mama wengi wanakuanga na anemia because of the way they eat. Actually, wa mama wengi, wale wanakufa hospitali during childbirth, most of the cases, na I think my fellow medical fraternity workers, they will agree with me. It is because of low blood pressure. By the time mama nazaa, sawa sawa, damu imetoka, blood pressure inaenda chini. Inafikia kiwango fulani ambacho kwamba blood pressure haiwezi rudi tena. Na mama anakufa. So most of the maternal and child deaths during childbirth are associated with poor nutrition. Sawa sawa? Yeah. So beans, please. Unaweza kula na papai, unaweza kula na machungwa, unaweza kula na nini tena? Zile zinaitwa tree tomato. Unaweza kula na nini? Pineapple and so on and so forth. So upange budget yako eh. So wakati unakula maharagwe and family, take them with sources of vitamin C. Tuko pamoja? Yes, then we go to fats. Eh? We are on the third type of nutrients. We said we have fats and oils. And we agreed that fats are solid at room temperature, and oils are liquid at room temperature. And as far as nutrition is concerned, we normally recommend that you take oils instead of fat. That is as per our current research. Although, some type of animal fats are good. They are not bad. And when you are, wale wa mama wakona mkona watoto, inaona wengine mko hapa, mkiwa na watoto kama wale, you don't, musiwakataze kula fats, food sources of fats. Hata hizo nyama, ambazo kwamba ziko na cholesterol. Watoto, their bodies, they don't make enough cholesterol. But for adults, their bodies make enough cholesterol. So adults, they don't need cholesterol from the food. But children, they don't make enough cholesterol. So watoto mkiwapatia nyama, na nyama iko na cholesterol, they are fine. Cholesterol pia ni muhimu because it is also used to make male and female hormones. Sijui kama mlijua hivyo? Kwa watoto wadogo, cholesterol ni mzuri. Wakinyimwa cholesterol, then I think their hormones will go haywire. And you know, hormones are very important because of growth and development, including development of, in the medical fraternity we mention everything, the growth of development of sexual organs. Are we together? Tuko pamoja?
Yes.
Young people, are we listening?
Yes.
Wale ambao kwamba hamjaoa, wale ambao kwamba mnajitayarisha kuoa, cholesterol for your children is very, very important, because it is also involved in synthesis of hormones. Tuko pamoja? Yeah. So for children, cholesterol is good, but for adults, no. It's a no because it affects your blood vessels. Yeah. So fats versus oil, you take. Can somebody give me examples of oils? Oils that you can find in the market. Eliandro is one of them. Sunflower oil is another one. Ufuta oil, gold, golden. Yes. Yeah, all those. So they are normally more expensive, and right now they are very, very expensive. Hiyo ndio shida tuko nayo. Yeah, lakini sasa ni wapi utatumia pesa zaidi? Ukikuwa mgonjwa? Si ukikuwa mgonjwa utatumia pesa nyingi sana. You'll use a lot of money when you go to the hospital. Yeah. So, upange ya budget. Afadhali utumie pesa kununua oil so that you can live a healthy life. Other than kungojea, ukifika 40 years, kila wiki unaenda hospitali kununua insulin na strips and other medications. Tuko pamoja? Yes. Yeah, because now it will be a lifetime problem. Yeah. I have seen many patients suffering financially. Paka wanakuwa broke because of they have to go to hospital to get medication. They have to go to hospital to buy strips and all sorts of things. Doctor visits and so on and so forth. So it is important. It's very important. Prevention is better than
cure.
So you better prevent diabetes mellitus. You better prevent cancer. You better prevent high blood pressure and other issues and other lifestyle diseases other than to wait until it is too late. Instead of you enjoying your money when you are 40, 50 years, then what you do? You'll be spending the same money visiting the doctor. So that is the other nutrient. And then we talked of minerals and vitamins. Minerals and vitamins, they are basically found in fruits and vegetables. But how do you make your vegetables? How do you cook them? Cooking methods. Maybe one sister can anaweza kunipati, kunyambia steps. How do you make your vegetables at home? Let's hear from one sister or one brother. Wale wanakaa, wale single brothers. How do you make your... Umeenda sokoni, ukanunua sukuma wiki. And you want to make your vegetables. Nichague mmoja. Aya. Inua mkono? Yes. Yes, let's hear from him.
Uya. Akuja second.
Naenda kwa mama mboga. Unamwambia kukata kati. Marunya nyanya. Kitungu na mafuta. Nakuja unakatakata kitungu, nyanya, mafuta unakoroga kwa sufuria. Na moto unatumbukiza na hiyo mama mboga alikuwekea. Mimi natengeneza kama hivyo.
I think it's sincere.
Ni maoni yake.
Yeah, anybody else?
Kati nilikuwa napika.
Wakati alikuwa napika. Yeah, that's a very good example. Anybody else? A sister? Let's have one sister. Okay, she wants to try.
Sister,
oh, you didn't try? I thought you raised your hand. Okay. Tell us.
Unaosha kwanza, unakata.
Unaosha kwanza?
Unakata.
Alafu unakata? Alafu, yes. So after kukata, how do you cook your vegetables now? After kukata the vegetables, how do you cook them? You steam. Somebody said you steam.
No.
Unachemsha.
Oh, unachemsha. Yeah, actually kuchemsha is boiling. That is a boiling method which is not recommended. It's not recommended. So, in conclusion, now we can hear different methods, different ways people cook their vegetables. Amesema, wana boil, yes?
God bless you.
Amen.
Amesema in conclusion, mi zangu pika hivi. Sipendi kukatakatiwa. Yes, kama ni sukuma wiki or spinach, I combine. Nabeba nyumbani mwenyewe najitengeneza, I wash them. Then I chop. Hiyo size napenda. After I chop, you have your green sufuria. Unakata kitungu yako vizuri. You kanga it to your portion venye unataka. Kama unataka ikue golden brown, whichever. Then uneka tomato.
Golden brown.
I don't use spices.
Yeah.
Kisha iva venye nataka, the tomatoes zimeiva. If you have a blender, you can use it, ndio hiyo ngozi sionekane. Then unakaanga vizuri, everything you mix, salt, kidogo, then unaweka mboga zako. You mix everything, unafunika kidogo, make sure your green isiishe. It's done kabisa. You moroka, then you serve it. You are green.
Naona brother andai. Atanona. Yes. Yeah, so we have had basically what we are learning here is people fry their vegetables. Sindio? Yeah, after frying the onions and the tomatoes with oil until maybe they turn zikwe rojo rojo, and then wanaweka their sukuma wiki, and then they fry them together. So that is called stir frying, yeah? Stir frying. You fry as you stir. So that's a cooking method. And that is where we are having problems, especially when we are cooking vegetables. So because vegetables, when you fry vegetables, you know oil and water, they boil at different temperatures. For oil to melt, it uses a very high temperature compared to water. So when you are cooking vegetables, it is recommended that you can steam the vegetables in very little water within a very short time. Sawa. Yeah. Ukisha osha hizo sukuma wiki na kuzikata to the design. Usikate zikuwe ndogo ndogo sana because you lose a lot of vitamins. Then you put them in a little water. Sawa. Or if you have something that is known as a steamer, yeah, because there are some steamers that are normally found in the supermarkets, they are about 3,000 or so. You can steam your vegetables instead of frying your vegetables. But you can fry your onions, you can fry your tomato, and you can stir them together. Sawa. And then the vegetables that is ready, then you take the vegetables and mix it with the stir-fried onions and tomatoes. And you can season, put salt as you finish cooking. Hiyo ni kazi, eh? So sister Andai, you kuna kazi, eh? Yes. So steam your vegetables, sawa, separately. Yeah, that is a lot of work. And that is why we are having problems, because we have no time. Hatuna time, hakuna time ya kupika. We would rather buy things that is known as fast foods, which we can cook very fast. So, but you have to spend time cooking your vegetables. Steam your vegetables separately, fry onions, tomatoes separately, mix them as you finish cooking. Season with salt and whatever spices, whatever you have. But spices is okay, by the way. Sawa. I like spices myself. Spices ziko sawa. But the problem, the main problem with cooking vegetables is the cooking method. When you fry vegetables, then the only thing that remains in the vegetables is fiber. So fiber is good, but at the end of the day, you will not get any vitamins from the vegetables if you fry them. So and we need those vitamins because of immunity. Yeah, vitamins are important for immunity. They are important for regulation of body processes and so on and so forth. There are so many things that vitamins are important for. Yeah. So minerals, we can always get from the same, from fruits and vegetables and so on and so forth. Yes. Cancers, eh? Because of a dirty system. Sawa. Yeah, for a prolonged period of time. So, fiber ni muhimu sana, mboga na matunda ni muhimu sana, na hata cereals, kidheri is very good, is a very good food. Kama upendi kidheri, so ujue kutoka leo, kwamba kidheri ni chakula kizuri sana, because it has...
Fagio.
Yeah. He's learning and he's very eager. Yeah, so it has... Yeah, kidheri has animal protein, it has a plant protein, it has whole carbohydrates, because the maize is not refined maize. So it has whole maize, and it has nutrients, it has iron, it has a lot of nutrients in it. Yeah, so kidheri is a very good food that can be taken by young people. See your chips, eh? Yeah, we shall revisit that topic. Yeah, so... basically those are nutrients that must be taken every day. So at any given time, you have to have those types of nutrients, including water. I will tell you how to take these nutrients in terms of quantities, sawa, and in terms of quality. Now we have the carbohydrates. Let me start with the carbohydrates. I told you I'll go back there. Now with carbohydrates, the problem we are having with society, with today's society, we are taking a lot of refined carbohydrates. Sawa. And examples of refined carbohydrates ni unga. Sijui inaitwa unga number one. Yeah, because ukienda kwa hizi kishagi, eh? Inaitwa kishagi? Yes. Kipeleka kishagi, eh? Ukienda kusaga unga, sawa, kuna ile unga iko rough kidogo, inaitwa unga number two. Sawa. And then ile unga, inaitwa?
Yenye imezekangi.
Ehe. Yenye wadada hawapendi kupika. Sijui ni wadada wangapi wanapikanga ile unga. Ile unga strong. Ukienda Western Kenya,
yes.
Ukienda
Meru,
Nyanza, Meru, where else? Yeah, those places, huh? Yeah, you'll find there, especially Western Kenya. Yes. Western Kenya, wanapika sana hiyo unga number two. Ile napelekwa kwa mtambo, inasagwa, and you are able to get that maize flour with all the nutrients imesagwa, imechanganywa pamoja. Yeah, so it is ground together. So in that unga, you have fiber, you have the epidermis, you have carbohydrates, you have all those things. You have the eliandro. Do you know where eliandro comes from?
Yes.
Eliandro inatoka kwa maize, eh? Yeah. So if you cook a whole maize, you're also taking very healthy fats, eh? That is known as eliandro. Are we together? Yeah. So you are taking everything. But what is happening in the society, what is affecting this modern society is the lifestyle. One of the things is because of lack of time. Hatujipei time ya kukula chakula. Hatujipei time ya kupika chakula mzuri. We don't take our time to cook. We prefer going for the fast foods. Eh? You can usha sikia kitu inaitwa fast foods. Yeah, fast foods, why is it called fast foods? Yeah, because of the fast, you know, everything is, tunafanya vitu haraka haraka, eh? Yeah, we want to cook within 5 minutes, chakula imeiva. Yeah, we want to eat very fast so that we can go back to work. Maybe we have 1 hour of a lunch hour, sawa sawa. And instead of taking our time to cook food, to cook nice food, that has all the nutrients and the ingredients, we want to take those foods that are very easy to cook, very light. Yeah, and those types of foods, number one, they lack the necessary nutrients. Number two, they spike, you know what spiking is? Yana pandisha the blood glucose. Because when carbohydrate is digested, then the product of carbohydrate digestion is glucose. So, and glucose is normally transported by something that is known as insulin. Yeah, I believe you all know what insulin is. Okay, insulin is a hormone. Sawa. It's a hormone that is produced by an organ that is known as the pancreas. Sawa. Yeah, pancreas. Sijui kwa Kiswahili naitwaje, nimesahau Kiswahili. Amos, pengine utanisaidia. Pancreas, you know there's a pancreas and the liver. But the function of pancreas, inatoa enzymes, sawa, enzymes, zinasaga chakula, sawa. Another thing that the pancreas produces, ni hormones. Kama insulin, na kuna nyingine inaitwa glucagon, sawa. Poleni sana, I will try to simplify things, eh? For your sake. So, ukikula tu carbohydrate, especially the very refined carbohydrate, then the blood glucose shoots. Inaenda hivi. Graph inaenda hivi. Ukienda kupimwa saa hiyo, wanakuta glucose iko labda 9. Sawa. If you have pre-diabetes. Eh? So what does insulin do? Insulin inachukua hiyo glucose, inaitoa kwa damu, inaipeleka wapi? Kwa cells. Sawa. So what happens if somebody does not produce enough insulin? Yeah, because tumekubaliana kwamba, ukikula carbohydrates, the refined ones, then the glucose level spike very fast. Eh? So what does insulin do? Inachukua, hiyo glucose, inapeleka kwa blood cells for further processing. But if somebody does not produce enough insulin, then the blood glucose remains high. Inabaki ikiwa juu. Ndio unasikia watu wakisema sukari yake imepanda, si ndio? Si mshasikia watu wakisema hivyo. Sukari imepanda. The blood glucose levels are very high because of probably a weak pancreas which is not producing enough insulin. That is number one. Sawa. Number two, pengine damaged pancreas. So that is one factor that can raise the blood glucose levels. So how do we control that? Yeah, and you can imagine every day you are taking refined foods. Every day, blood glucose levels is in a spike. What will happen? You will be overworking your pancreas. And if you do it over a prolonged period of time, then finally the pancreas will malfunction. You'll start having problems of insulin production. Sawa. So how do we overcome that? We recommend that you take a diet that is rich in fiber. Sawa. Alongside with your ugali, ile ugali ambayo kwamba unapenda sana, or rice, you have to take it with vegetables, sawa, which nutrient? Fiber, sawa. What does fiber do? It filters, Fiber ni kama kichungi, sawa. Kama ile kichungi ya chai. Tuko pamoja, ile kichungi ya chai, ukiweka chai hivi ikiwa na majani mengi, inachunga hiyo chai kuingia kwa kikombe. So what fiber does, it acts like a sieve, and it controls the amount of glucose entering the blood. So in other words, it limits the amount of glucose. Inaingiza glucose kidogo kidogo kwa damu. Sawa. So that spiking of glucose levels is normally, now instead of the graph going like this, the graph inakuwa hivi. Yeah? Sawa. Yeah. So that is number one. Carbohydrates must be taken with fiber. Tuko pamoja? Yeah. So anytime you are taking refined carbohydrates, you have to realize that you have to take them with fiber. Number two recommendation in terms of carbohydrates, please try as much as possible to take those carbohydrates that are not refined. Nduma, we have whole maize and those type of carbohydrates. Tuko pamoja? And no wonder we are having issues with so many people suffering from diabetes mellitus type 2. Diabetes mellitus type 2 is caused by repeatedly taking very refined carbohydrates. Sweet things, a lot of sweet things, a lot of fat, because those are the diets that are available. Those are the diets that we call them fast foods. Those are the diets that if you go to Nairobi now and you want something very quick, in any fast food restaurant, you'll get your chips, sawa, and you'll get your, of course, chips are normally fried in, they are normally dipped in fat. So you can imagine anything that is dipped in fat, inachukua mafuta yote, sindio? Yeah, so when you are taking those fast foods, you are taking refined carbohydrates or starch, you are also taking what? A lot of fats at the same time. So it results in a lot of accumulation of fats in the body and sugars in the body. And it puts you at risk of diabetes mellitus type 2. You may not know, lakini ukianza kufikia 40 years, 50 years, those effects zinaanza kuwa felt. Are we together, youth? Tuko pamoja? Yeah. So please, we need you to, yes, to remain healthy. You must remain healthy. Sisters and brothers, please take your time when you are cooking. Food choices, please, mchague zile choices ambazo kwamba ziko na fiber ya kutosha. When you go for shopping, take your time. When you are cooking, take your time. Number two, proteins. We have two types of proteins. We have plant proteins. We also have animal proteins. How many love chicken? Ni watu wangapi wanapenda kuku? almost everybody. Mnaonea waluya sana. Yeah, waluya sana. Yeah. So chicken is a very good animal protein. Then we have beef that comes from cows and goats. Sawasawa, it is also a very good animal protein. Then we have fish. It's also a very good animal protein. In nutrition, we have these principles of white meat versus red meat. Sawasawa, white meat ni ile nyama ambayo kwamba inatoka kwa samaki na inatoka kwa kuku. Sawasawa, and even rabbits. Sawasawa, rabbits, they are also very good sources of white meat. So if you are eating rabbit meat, you are eating white meat. Then red meat, nyama ya ngombe, nyama ya mbuzi, mutton, sawasawa, and pork, all those things. Now, as far as the research is going on, of course, there's a lot of research. Nutrition is very, 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 very wide, and there's a lot of research, there's a lot of information that is being published every now and then. Yeah, so there are so many theories that are coming that too much intake of red meat is associated with a lot of the cancers that we are taking. And then red meat, too much intake of red meat. Of course, red meat, the meat that comes from cows and goats, has something that is known as cholesterol. Cholesterol ni ile mafuta ambayo kwamba yana yako ndani ya nyama ya mbuzi ama ya ngombe. Sawa sawa? Ya cholesterol. So what is cholesterol? Cholesterol is a type of fat that is normally when you take it in your diet, then inaenda kwa mishipa. Ikifika kwa mishipa, then ina accumulate kwa hiyo mishipa. So when it accumulates in the blood vessels, then the blood vessels will start becoming thin. And the more you take the meat, the thinner your blood vessels will become very thin. Katikati ya hiyo mishipa, kuna kashimo inaitwa lumen. Sasa hiyo lumen inaendelea kuwa very narrow. It will continue narrowing. So the more you expose yourself to cholesterol, the narrower the lumen will be. So you can imagine, ukifika 40 years, what will happen. Yeah. And when the lumen narrows, then there will be buildup of high blood pressure because now the heart will use a lot of pressure to move the blood from one point of the body to another because of the very narrow lumen. So red meat is associated with those kind of problems. It is associated with cholesterol. It is also associated with what? With cancers. Are we together? Yes. Then we have white meat. White meat comes from, we said fish and chicken. Sawasawa. I don't know how many people remove the skin when they are taking their chicken. Yeah, because there's a very nice skin there. Ukichinja kuku, alafu ukipika hiyo kuku, sawasawa, kuna ile ngozi ya kuku hapo. Especially ile kuku ya kienyeji. Unakula yote. Yes, and it is the sweetest part of a chicken. Sindio? Why? It is because of the fat in the chicken. You know, fat is normally stored under the skin. Sawasawa. Any animal stores fat under the skin. Kwa hivyo ukikula kuku na ngozi yake, then what are you taking? A lot of cholesterol. Sawasawa, tumekubaliana kwamba cholesterol ni mbaya, si ndio? Yes.
So tutupe. Tutupe.
So Waluya and the rest. Mtafanya nini? Yes, if you want. Yes, ama utakuwa mgonjwa, utaenda hospitali, sawa sawa. And you'll meet some of us, sawa sawa. Kwa hivyo, when you are taking chicken, tafadhali, jaribu ku.
Kikura mama ijapiko, mama kambit, ama kambit vila kulanga
ikiwe. Okay.
Kona madara yote.
Yeah. Yes. Cabbage ukikula. Cabbage ukikula kama haijapikwa, there's a substance. Remember when I was introducing nutrition, nilitaja kitu kinaitwa anti-nutrients. Sawa sawa. So raw cabbage iko na anti-nutrient ambayo inaitwa goitrogen. Let me not. Lakini wewe ujue kwamba cabbage ina kitu inaitwa anti-nutrient. So what does the anti-nutrient do? It combines, it binds the nutrient. Inaishikilia namna hii. So the nutrient will not benefit your body. Sawa sawa. So you can cook your cabbage, sawa sawa, for some time. You don't have to cook it until it is so cooked. You can cook it for very few minutes, so that you retain some of the nutrients. Sawa sawa. But don't eat raw cabbage, because it has anti-nutrients. Tuko pamoja? Yeah. So, anti-nutrients are also found in kales. They are also found in spinach. Sawa sawa. Yeah, what anti-nutrients do, they bind iron. So ile iron ambayo kwamba, yeah, spinach, by the way, spinach is a very good source of iron, eh? Pia. But the problem, if you don't cook it at all, then it binds the iron and you'll not get the benefit of the spinach. So you'll have to cook the iron, I mean the spinach, for some time. You don't have to cook it for a very long time, but at least cook it for some time. You can also take salads. Munajua salads, vegetable salads. Yeah, you kama kachumbari, of course, if you take you cut some tomatoes and onions and what else?
Cucumber.
Yeah, those are very, very good things. Those are things that you can take raw. And you can get the full benefit of the raw vegetables from the which provide a lot of vitamins and minerals. But cabbage, please, cabbage ikona sumu kidogo. Ikona sumu kidogo.
Tena.
Hiyo sumu inaitwa? Yes, in the form of anti-nutrient. So, if you take raw cabbage for a very long period of time, then the poison that is accumulating in your body will give you problems after some time. Cassava, same thing, eh? Ya, najua kuna watu wengine wanakula raw cassava.
Yes.
But have you heard of people that have died because of taking raw cassava?
Yes.
Ni nini inaua watu? Hizo anti-nutrients, eh? And one of them, actually, some of the cassava ziko na substance ambayo inaitwa cyanide. Sawa sawa. Have you heard of cyanide? Cyanide ni sumu nyingine mbaya sana ambayo ukikula unaweza kufa. Just a small molecule of cyanide can kill you. Then there's also a substance that is known as goitrogen that is also found in cassava, which also binds iron and other vitamins.
But we have two types of cassavas.
Yes.
Yeah, we have yenyeza kukuwa na
kuna. Yes. Kuna the poisonous type, yeah, which can kill you. Yeah, but how do you know which is the poisonous type? That is the problem. And that is why people have died. Yeah, because of gambling. Yeah, sometimes it is difficult to tell which is the poisonous type unless you are a real expert. So we advise people not to take raw cassava. Not just because of the cyanide, because cyanide can kill instantly, but there's because of goitrogen. Goitrogen in a bind your iron. So it is not recommended for anybody to eat raw cassava.
Sawa.
So I think we have covered almost all the nutrients. Let's go to the water. So we have talked about carbohydrates, we have talked about proteins, we have talked about fats, oils and fats. We have talked about minerals. We have talked about cooking methods so that you can benefit from them, minerals and vitamins. There's one nutrient that is remaining, water, maji. How many know the quantity of water that we are supposed to take in a day?
And
a day is 24 hours.
Eight glasses.
That is very good. So how do you take the 8 glasses of water? How do you take 8 glasses? Do you take them once? Unakunyoka sangapi?
Baada ya kukula.
Baada ya kukula, okay. Yeah, that is where we are getting to. Now, the brother is saying, anakunywa maji baada ya kula. What time should we take water? In between meals, eh? Sawa. We should not take water with food. We should take water in between meals. Do you know what happens when you take your water with food? Yeah, because the moment you take food, then the body normally releases enzymes. Inapima zile enzymes, ambazo kwamba zinaenda kusaga chakula. Sawa. So, ukikunywa maji, what will happen to those enzymes? Ukikunywa maji immediately. It will dilute the enzymes. Yeah. And the enzymes will not work the way they are supposed to work. Because of intake of water immediately after eating. So what do we recommend? We normally recommend that you take water at least half an hour after meals. Sawa. Or half an hour to 1 hour. Or if you want, you can take water in between meals so that you don't interfere with the digestion process. Are we together, youth? Tunelewana? Yeah, so usikunywe maji na chakula pamoja. Ungoje, chakula kikisagwa, then in fact if you'll get used. If you take water in between meals, you'll get used and you'll not have a problem. The reasons that some people take water with meals is because they wait until the time of meals. That is the time they are taking water. Kwa hivyo, by the time they are taking food, they are very, very thirsty. So inabidi wakunywe maji wakati huo. But in order for you to avoid thirst, what do? You take water between meals. Then you will not feel that effect of dryness when you are eating food. Are we together? Yes. So we have finished the classes of nutrients. We are finishing, eh? I'm finishing. I promise that I'll take 10 minutes. Yeah, because today was just an introduction. And I think I will get time because nutrition is very wide. I told you it covers all the stages of life, including children, including pregnant mothers. Maybe I'll talk with pregnant mothers, possibly one time. I can talk with lactating mothers one time. I can talk with adolescents, wale wamefika 13 years, and their parents, because maybe I would like their parents to hear what they need to hear. And we also have nutrition for people like you, adults, because we are affected by the kind of life that we live. Yeah, including skipping meals. Yeah, a lot of youth skip meals. Yeah, because of the pressure of life. Economy, yes. Yeah, economy is a very, very important factor. Yeah, so we skip meals because life is very hard and we cannot blame people. But ukienda soko yoyote hapa Nairobi, huwezi kosa. Ukitaka kununua chakula cheap, tafadhali usinunue kwa estate, uende wapi?
Marikiti.
Marikiti, eh? Ma wakulima hata mimi huwa naenda huko eh. wakulima ama Githurai kuna soko kubwa. Zile masoko kubwa kubwa, that is where you can get things at a very cheap price. So but when you go to the estates, then food is sold at a very high price and you may not afford. And it will become strenuous after some time, and you will continue with your kind of lifestyle that you are living. So in lakini kwa masoko utapata nduma very cheap, utapata waru, utapata all sorts of foods at very cheap prices. So musikuwa wavivu kwenda kwa masoko kufanya shopping huko. Ladies and gentlemen, especially the gentlemen, maybe the ladies try, but gentlemen, especially the single ones, please, tafadhali, mwe mnatembea huko kwa masoko. Tuko pamoja? Yes. Yeah, so I want to stop there so that I give you an opportunity to ask some few questions, maybe 5 questions, and then we call it a day. Unless there's something that is not clear. I don't know if there's anything that is not clear for today. Maybe we'll revisit in another dimension another day. Okay, she wants me to repeat, I explained a bit of the relationship between insulin and glucose. Huh? Okay, I don't know whether, is there anybody else who has a problem with the relationship between insulin and glucose? Kwa hivyo hamkuelewa? Hamkuelewa? Okay. Okay, let me just repeat. So I said, if you take a meal that is rich in carbohydrates, sawa sawa, when carbohydrates are digested in the body, then glucose is released. And then glucose is absorbed and it is taken into the blood. Sawa sawa. Once glucose is taken into the blood, then what does the body do? It sends signals to the brain. In our brain, una glucose imeingia kwa blood. So signals are sent to the pancreas. Ile organ inaitwa pancreas, which is next to the liver. So what does the pancreas do? It releases a substance that is known as insulin. Insulin ndio inachukua, inaishika glucose namna hii, inaipeleka wapi? Kwa blood cells. Tuko pamoja? So in other words, insulin inatoa glucose from the blood, inaipeleka wapi? Kwa cells. That is where glucose is needed. Because kwa cells za mwili, that is where energy is produced. Energy inakuwa produced ndani ya cells. Na glucose isipopelekwa ndani ya cells, then utakuwa unajisikia weak, utakuwa unajisikia kusinzia, you will lack energy because there's no glucose that has been taken to the cells. And that process is done by which, by what? By insulin. Are we together? Yes. So kazi ya insulin ni kuchukua glucose kutoka kwa blood, inaitoa, inapeleka wapi? Kwa cells. In the cells, that is where now the glucose provides or is converted into a molecule of energy. Sawa sawa?
Yes.
But if there isn't enough insulin that is produced by the pancreas, what happens? Blood glucose levels zinabaki juu. Zikibaki juu, then what does the body do? The body will try to, it will do something so that blood glucose inaenza kwenda chini. So inajaribu kuitoa hata kupitia kwa mikojo. Are we together?
Yes.
Yeah, in fact, sometimes back, zamani sana, walikuwa na wanapima mtu, wakitaka kujua kama mtu wako na diabetes ama la, walikuwa wana test mikojo. Sawa sawa. So, ikiwa mikojo iko sweet, that means there is elevated glucose in the blood that is not taken to the cells. Sawa sawa. Because what does the body do? Inaitoa kupitia kwa kidneys. Tuko pamoja? It's a bit technical, eh? It's a bit technical. So, basically that is what happens. Sister, I hope I have put it in a very simple way. Yeah. So, kazi ya insulin ni kutoa glucose kutoka kwa damu, kuipeleka wapi? Kwa cells za mwili. If that process fails, then first of all, that individual will lack energy in his body. Number two, there'll be elevated blood glucose levels. And of course, elevated blood glucose levels zinaleta shida in the future. Shida moja inaharibu macho. Glucose levels zikikuwa juu kwa muda mrefu sana, macho inaanza kuharibika. Lakini sio yangu, eh? Yango si kwa sababu ya glucose. Yes. Macho inaanza kuharibika. Secondly, mtu anapata stroke because of elevated glucose levels. Thirdly, anakuwa na shida ya moyo. So there will be cardiovascular issues. Sawa sawa. And I will tell you this because you are youth. Sawa sawa. What happens if the glucose levels remain high? Inaharibu nini? Kidneys. Kidneys inaanza kuharibika pole pole. Hapo sio mwisho. Mtu ambaye akona sukari, elevated glucose levels. And I'm telling you this because you are youth and you are the parents of tomorrow. What will happen to your sexual organs? You'll not perform. Yes. Yes, because of actually, elevated glucose levels, they damage the small blood vessels, including the macho and the sexual organs. Not just for male, for male and female. Eh? So sisters, you can imagine if you're in a situation where you don't feel like, eh? It will bring, is here to let a shida? Yes, that desire. You don't have any desire for sex. So, because you are the future parents. Huh? I hope I'm not... you'll forgive me for this, because I have to tell you. So for the gentleman, it will affect your sexual performance. So, and it will strain your relationship with your sister. For the sister, it will strain your relationship with the brother. So it is both ways. Eh? So tumeelewana?
Yes.
Yeah. Sukari, eh? So to avoid refined carbohydrates, eh? Yeah. So maybe I can answer that question. And then I have some questions here, one or two questions, and then we'll revisit another day.
My question was about, first of all, microwave, the way we boil food in microwave, then the way we preserve food through refrigeration, unapika beans, then you una refrigerate for like a week. Does it have any
effect? I don't know whether I got the question properly, but you are talking about the use of microwave oven. Yeah, because microwave ovens basically they cook food through radiation. Sawa sawa. So zinapika food through radiation. But scientifically speaking, microwave. You know there are two types of radiation. Kuna ile radiation ambayo inaleta cancer. which is called ionizing radiation. But ile radiation ya microwave is not ionizing. So it is not the dangerous type of radiation. So, but there's still research as far as the use of microwave is concerned. Because there are so many people that are worried and they are not comfortable with foods being cooked by radiation. So microwave generally, as per our current research findings, microwave ovens hazina madhara ya afya, because the type of radiation that comes from microwave is non-ionizing radiation. Ile radiation ambayo kwamba ina cause, inaweza kuleta shida, ni ile radiation, ukienda kwa x-ray, how many have, you know x-ray, yeah? Ya ukienda kupimwa, kama uko mgonjwa, sehemu fulani, wanakupiga picha, na hizo rays ambazo kwamba wanatumia, za x-ray. In fact, they normally don't recommend a continuous exposure of x-rays because those type of rays have ionizing radiation. So they are very dangerous. But still rays is a microwave, ni rays ambazo kwamba hazina ionizing radiation. So you can actually use microwave oven to heat your food. Sawa. But I'm not saying that you use microwave to cook your food. Sawa. So when cooking your food, tafadhali tumia the conventional way of cooking food. Sawa. Lakini mambo ya kupika chakula, kila chakula, mboga, sijui nini, unapika na microwave, hiyo pia you will also be exposing yourself to inconclusive research. They are actually researching, they are doing more research on the use of microwave oven. Sijui kama nimekujibu. So you can use microwave, especially when you are heating food. Uko na haraka, unaweza ku. You can use your microwave to heat your food. But don't make it a habit to cook food using microwave oven. Otherwise, according to current scientific research, zile rays za microwave sio mbaya, sio kama zile za x-ray. I hope nimekujibu.
Fridge.
Of refrigerator, fridge. I think is basically used to preserve food. Eh? So fridge haina shida. The only problem with refrigerator foods, they are not fresh. Eh? Yeah, you know, refrigerator foods, they are not fresh. So sometimes it depends on the way, because we normally teach students how to store food, different types of foods. But it depends on the way you store food. Sometimes you can expose yourself to microorganisms, kama hujui kutumia, or kama hujui kustore chakula fulani the way it is. So there are many ways of, there are certain recommendations for storing certain types of foods, which you have to learn. So when you are using refrigerator, you have to be careful. You have to learn, kama ni nyama, know where to store the meat. Ukitoa nyama, kule kwa deep freezer, hapo juu si kuna deep freezer. Labda imeshika barafu, sindio? Then, for you to prepare it, you have to leave it for some time in a process that is known as thawing, sindio? So when it is thawing, that is the time that microorganisms zinaweza kuingia kwa hiyo nyama. So you have to know how to. Immediately after removing meat from the deep freezer, remove the piece that you want to cook. Na ile nyingine uiregeshe immediately. Isikae hapo. Otherwise, inaweza cause a lot of food poisoning. Na food poisoning inaweza kuua. Inaweza kukuua. So you have to be very careful with the way you handle food using the fridge. Sawa. I hope I have answered you. So let me answer some two questions here. Somebody is asking, is green tea healthy to take? Okay, I will answer that. Green tea, because there's green tea and black tea. And green tea is made in a different way from black tea. because of the fermentation process, is a bit different. So green tea is normally considered a very healthy tea. Number one, ikona substances inaitwa antioxidants. Antioxidants ni substances ambazo kwamba zinatoa sumu kwa cells. Antioxidants, they are found in fruits, they are found in vegetables. So green tea pia ikona hizo vitu zinaitwa antioxidants. Actually, the reason people are getting a lot of cancers nowadays, hizi makansa mingi mingi hizi, it is because of these substances that are known as oxidants that are found in the cells. So what all antioxidants do, they just enter the cells, and once they enter the cells, they remove those oxidants. So what, that is the one function of green tea. So green tea is actually healthy to take. But when you are taking tea, sawa sawa, I know most of us love tea, including myself. Neema na Adita Walino, and Nagea. So I love tea. Yeah, and I think a number of Luyas love tea. And Kalenjins, Rift Valley. So, but when you are taking tea, please take tea without the main food. Because tea has something that is known as tannin. There are substances known as tannin inside the tea. What do tannins do? They combine with iron. So they bind iron, and you will not benefit from iron. When you go to Western Kenya, they are very fond of taking tea and njugu in the morning. Sindio? Si wanakula chai na njugu in the morning. Yeah, that habit is not recommended. Sawa sawa. So long as you take them separately, there's no problem. So you take your peanuts with something else, maybe with the juice. If you can take them with juice, the better. Sawa sawa. But when you take tea, you can either take tea half an hour after your njugu, sawa sawa, or 30 minutes before your peanuts. Are we together? Yeah, so ukikula njugu zako, if you love njugu, if you love ngwashe, please separate them with your tea. Take tea afterwards or before. Recommended time? Half an hour. A lot of do's and don'ts, Yeah, but it is for your benefit, Remember, if you accumulate these toxins for a limited time, for an extended period of time, ukifika 40 years, you will start feeling the effects of poor nutrition. Ata ngwashe na chai. So you can take ngwashe, of course ngwashe huwezi kula sikiwa dry. You can take them with a little water. Or juice. Yeah, ngwashe is also a very good source of iron. Yeah. So there's another question here. What is your advice? I think I've answered that regarding refrigerated food. So what is your advice to someone who is allergic to animal proteins? There's no problem if you're allergic to animal proteins. Then it's recommended that you combine a number of plant proteins. Don't take one source of plant proteins. Combine as many plant proteins as possible, including soya. Soya is a very good, actually soya has all the, there are substances that are known as amino acids. Amino acids is the smallest molecule of a protein. So soya, ile maharagwe inaitwa soya, ikona all the essential amino acids kama zile ambazo kwamba ziko kwa nyama. Yeah. So you can combine as many plant foods as possible. Variety is the key. Sawa sawa? So variety, take a variety of them and you'll be fine. So maybe I can answer another question. Is taking water in between meals means taking a bit of meal and water together? No. So I think I've answered that. Is pepper harmful in any way to our bodies? If not, what is its importance? Pepper is especially red pepper. I love it myself. Red pepper is a very good source of vitamin A, sawa. So if you take pepper, then you are taking vitamin A. It's a very good source of vitamin A. Yeah, so I think with that, we shall stop there for today. Nutrition haimaliziki. Iko na so many things. And I think we need to go and take a rest for today. Some of you have been here at 5, and I don't want to keep you for longer. Thank you.
Makofi mzuri. Thank you so much, Brother Komora.